Okay, hello and welcome back everyone. Today I'm Kevin from KevKevMC, and what I have here is Yashika GTN, I mean GSN, which one of you viewers have suggested me like adapt this thing, which I will do. This thing has a dead thingy right here. I've cocked this thing. Shutter will press down. Wait, let me unlock it, but it does not click, which I think is a bad of death. So if I can fix this thing, which I'm not gonna fix it, see this thing's also dropped down inside there, it's like loose as heck. And everything's broken essentially. The viewfinder's fucked up and the lens has some funky in it. Although and this front thing actually turns about, it's like which is odd as heck. I've tried opening this thing up with no fill. And so I might have to cut this thing out. Like cut the front ring out. Then final with like take the front ring out, which I think is done by unscrewing three little screws. That's if I'm not mistaken. So yeah. Then the focus on this is actually really nice. It's really smooth helicoid. So I really do hope that this thing can actually be a candidate for a video, which I adapt this thing to Sony E-mount, which I do not have an E-mount camera right now. Because the fact that I sold the A6000, and yeah, so I'm trying to get a A6400 on the channel, hopefully. And I've also got this like case for the Yashica, it's original leather case, pretty disgusting. I've not washed it, gonna do so later. It smells like old stuff, which is to be expected. Yeah, then this is my old Yashica part slot from the Yashica Electro 35 GT. I think I still have the GT actually. Let me go show you. So here's the GT right here on my table. It's in bits because I've got something planned for this thing. But yeah, this is the GT, which I thought could be a nice little donor for that thing, but the shutter winding bits don't fit together, so not sure how that's gonna go. Then let me go show you the next thing I have, which is this Konica MF, I think it's called 35 C35 MF. I've seen these things go for pretty expensive around here, yeah. It's even got that like what you call this thing? Like that certified or something like that sticker, yeah. Then it's got this case which is I think original, I'm not sure. It does fit this thing perfectly. And it's also got this tethered lens cap right here, yeah. Then it's got this filter. Oh, yeah, I forgot to mention that the Yashica actually has some funky in it in the front and the back, which is gonna be a challenge because Yashica lenses are hard to work on. They take like a ton of torque on these tools right here. And so if you're starting out, I don't recommend playing with these things. Then for this, the battery door's broken. Me go show you right here, yeah. It does power on but sort of doesn't work. Let me go show you how what I mean by that. So this is, see, this seems like the minus terminal. And this thing seems like the plus terminal, yeah. So let's put this guy in. And let me go charge the flash. Let's turn flash on. And you can actually see a red light in there once I press the. See? It's charging right now. It's making that sound, but there's no red light, yeah. Let's turn this thing on. I think this is step, but this thing has no steps at all. So it might be broke. It should be broken. And this is the rewind thingy, which is also broken. Shutter counter should work because it's at S. And it is at S because I do not have any film in it. Let me go push this thing down. How the heck did I even open it? Yeah, okay. There you go. This is the Konica. It's pretty clean inside. Although the electronics do not work. Go spit out the batteries. And yeah, okay, so that's essentially this December. I'm gonna have a Fuji X100 also arrive here, yeah. And maybe another A7S, maybe an A6400. I'm not sure about that, but let's see. If you do have any like requests, you can just say like you want some kind of camera to be on the channel. Then I might try it out if it's actually viable. Like, don't just say buy like some kind of crazy expensive heck camera like the A7S III. I'm not gonna do that, but these are still in the price range I can actually afford. So yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you liked the video. Subscribe for more stuff, cause this stuff is always gonna continue until I don't know, until I can't really do it anymore. Yeah. So yeah, thank you and goodbye.